Hello there. Today, I will walk you through setting up and running Flink queries on a dedicated PrivateLink Kafka cluster in Confluent Cloud. I will cover everything from creating the cluster to running your first query, breaking it down to simple, manageable steps. In the first section of this video, I will create a dedicated Kafka cluster in Confluent Cloud. Next, I will set up a VPC in AWS Cloud. I will configure private link between dedicated cluster in Confluent Cloud and AWS VPC. From that, I will set up EC2 instance to deploy in my VPC, from where I will be accessing my Kafka cluster. Next, we will set up reverse proxy, and we will finally access our data in Kafka topics from Flink. So let's get to it. Now, from this Confluent Cloud window, I need to navigate to my environments, find particular environment, and click Add Cluster. So for this demonstration, I will go with dedicated cluster with two CKUs and click Begin Configuration. I will deploy my cluster in AWS, and I will select US East because it's closer to me in multi-zone setup. Click Next. I will select PrivateLink as my network configuration. I will create a new one. Let's call it AWS PrivateLink 2 because I have previously configured private links. With access to this link will be available through Zone 1, Zone 2, and Zone 4. Let's enable resource metadata access in order to see some of the cluster metadata in Confluent Cloud UI. Click Continue, and I'll select automatic provisioning of encryption keys. And from this, let's name it something like Victor Cluster 42, because it sounds very, very cool. Now, from this window, it will take you a few seconds or maybe minutes to provision this dedicated cluster. Be patient, and cluster will change the status from provisioning to up and running. Now, at this point, we have our dedicated cluster created, but we see this message that cluster networking setup is incomplete. So let's fix that. In this configuration, we need to create a private link access to connect my AWS account with my dedicated cluster. So let's click this private link access. Name, let's call it AWS VPC 2. And I need to provide my account number. I'm going to my AWS console and I can find this here, my account number, enter here. And the Confluent Cloud UI generated VPC service endpoint that we're gonna be using on the next screen. Click Add. We need to wait a few seconds until this link will be provisioned. Now it's ready. I'm switching back into my AWS console and going into VPC section. I already have a VPC created in three zones, US East A, B, and D. And next thing is that I need to create endpoint. Click create endpoint. Endpoint service that uses NLB or gateway load balancer. Click here. Entering this VPC service. Click verify. Service is verified. I am selecting my VPC. And I am selecting my zones. For this case, I will be using my private subnet. I'll keep this security group as is, and I click create endpoint. So let's call it dedicated endpoint. After a few moments, when our endpoint will be provisioned, we'll see this update in progress message will disappear. And now we need to only configure DNS zones for this to work. And so I can connect my EC2 instance to my Kafka cluster. Now we go into Route 53, which is service that Amazon provides in order to manage all things DNS in Amazon Cloud. So I'm going to the hosted zones. We create new hosted zone. We copy this DNS domain from Confluent Cloud. Here, we're gonna do this private hosted zone. we will choose US East and my VPC that I have here configured. So create hosted zones. Now, the next thing is that would be a little bit interesting that, you know, you need to pay attention to this part because, you know, something will not work. It always will be DNS. Now, the next thing is that we need to create records in this zone for the domain and zonal subdomains. For this subdomain, it's going to be star. Address will be this service, DNS name of the service. And we need to create a CNAME record. Now, next thing is that another CNAME record and subdomain. This one's going to be zonal. So we need to use this for AZ1. And how I can find this? This one of those will be a zonal. So as I can see here, US1 AZ1, it is US1D. So I need to find the one with US1D. This is the DNS name for this. Adding another record, another CNAME, another star dot. We're gonna do with AZ2 and EZ2 is gonna be 1A. So that's 1A. And another record for AZ4, CNAME, and 1B, AZ4, and we click create record. In a few seconds, everything will be provisioned and we will be ready to test our connectivity with our EC2 instance that deployed in this VPC. Okay, at this point, we should see our cluster is up and running, our private link is working. So we should be able to do something with this cluster. So first of all, let's take a look inside and if we can see the topics. After a few seconds, we should see the message that we cannot create these topics or do something because this cluster is protected by private network. However, we can now access to this Kafka cluster through EC2 instance where I have Confluent CLI is installed. Now, if I go to Confluent, I can see my cluster. That's my dedicated clusters. Now, let's take a look if we can see any topics available in this cluster. Now, we can create topics and populate those topics with some data. There's a command called create. We need to specify name of the topic, number of partitions. Let's call it my topic. And let's do like 12 partitions. We can see the topic is created. Now we can configure something like a data gen connector. Now you can see here, topic is appeared. So we can see, but we cannot access to this topic. So let's add a connector. Sample data, stock trades. We're going to launch this. We're going to use my topic to populate this data. Create API keys for this connector. We generate them in JSON format just for simplicity. Connector gonna start in a few seconds and we will start seeing some messages in my topic. Now, connecting is up and running and we do have some messages flowing into Kafka topic. Again, we cannot see anything, but we should be able to consume this from command line. So if I go to topic consume, and I'll just do Confluent, I need to create the API key. And we need to copy my secret. the messages with trades are flowing in. So our dedicated cluster deployed and connected to my VPC where I'm running my EC2 instance. Now, let's test how Flink works with this cluster. In my list of topics, I need to select my topic and click Query with Flink. As you can see here, Confluent Cloud UI was able to infer my topic and include my environment, my Kafka cluster, and topic name. When I click Run, it will take a few seconds to Flink to initialize this query and start getting messages from my topic. And as you can see here, as a result, we have 3 records because we limited result of this topic. And the reason why it works is in 2 simple things. So first of all, when we're coming back to my environment and we go to Flink, we can find a list of endpoints where Flink will be accessed from. In this particular case, we're using PrivateLink and we're using private regional endpoint. We need to configure our hosts, so our proxy server that will be running inside our EC2 VPC will have access to outside world, and our browser UI that is outside of VPC will have access to this endpoint through this VPC proxy. Inside my etc hosts, I have Flink endpoint configured pointing to IP address of my proxy configured, and also another endpoint that is used by frontend in order to report some errors and IntelliSense. And if I'll show you how my Nginx configuration looks like, you will be able to find this information in documentation how you can configure this, but at this point, 2 things. So this reverse proxy will be able to proxy request that goes into Kafka protocol to the port 9092, as well as to HTTPS traffic that also will be going inside AWS, and also it will be using AWS specific resolver. If you will be running PrivateLink in something else than AWS, you will need to use specific resolver for Azure or for Google Cloud, but for Amazon, we're going to be using this IP address. So every request that will be coming in into this reverse proxy will be forwarded to instances of the DNS resolver inside AWS that also will be pointing to these hosted zones that we configured before. Again, same thing for Bootstrap server for Kafka and for Flink. I hope you found this video useful and now you understand how you can create dedicated cluster in Confluent Cloud and connect to instances of your application that run in AWS in your virtual private cloud. So let me quickly recap what we just did. So first of all, we created a dedicated cluster inside Confluent Cloud. We provisioned Flink runtime so we can access this data. Now, we also created PrivateLink service in order to connect the infrastructure that's available in AWS Cloud. Specifically, we configured how all this resolution will happen and how we can discover all these nodes through this like VPC endpoints. Also, there is a Nginx proxy that will be proxying all the requests on Kafka protocol 9092 port TCP and also on HTTPS protocol 443 port. EC2 instance contains the Confluent Cloud CLI that allows us to communicate to this Kafka cluster. So when we accessing different tools or our application will be accessing our Confluent Cloud, this is how your traffic will be flowing. So hope this will make sense. And with this, my name is Victor Gamov, and as always, have a nice day.